بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. A quick recap on what we have done previously. الحمد لله. We said that the person who wants to study Tajweed, there are two things he has to know in order to understand Tajweed correctly. Isn't that what we said? What was the first thing that we said you have to know? Makharij al-Huruf. How many types did we say the Makharij al-Huruf is? Huh? Makharij al-Huruf is how many types? Huh? What were the two that we said? مخارج وشوا فرعية لا صفات مخارج we said that فرعية and those which were the أصل and those which were the فروع. We said if we break it into فروع, how many types did we say? The أصل is how many? Five. And from within those five we said how many come out of it? مخارج الحروف 17. And we took that, correct? Yes. Yes, no? Yes. Once we finished that, we moved on to what? Sifat. We said the second thing that a person needs to know after studying Makharij al-Huruf is Sifat al-Huruf. And we said that the Sifat al-Huruf is how many types? Two types. The first type we said is what? Sifat lazima and Sifat عارضة. Sifat لازمة, we divided into how many? Into two. Sifat لازمة into two. The first type we said is what? ذات الضد. What does ذات الضد mean? It is those sifat that have opposites. And how many were they? Five. Sifat ذات الضد was how many? Five. And how many came out? Six. Remember when we came to the رخوة, we توسط and we discussed that? There was a sixth one that was mentioned. Go back to... There was six that came out. So it's five with five and one had two opposites. Please go back to your notes. And after sifat lazima, sorry, after the dhatul did, we took what? So sifat lazima is two types, dhatul did and sifat la didda laha. Sifat la didda laha, how many types did we say it was? Seven. And the last one that we took was what? Al-Istitala was the last one that we took, and the Safir was the first one that we took. Okay? What's the second type of a Sifat al-Huruf? Sifat Arida. Sifat Arida and Sifat Lazima, the difference is, as you can see from the name, Sifat Lazima, Jazari mentions it, is Haqqul Harf. It's the rights that the letter has. This letter, this is something that it has every time in every situation. Whereas sifat arida means it has it sometimes and sometimes it doesn't have it. It's arid, meaning it is common to the word. Okay? It's not always the case. That's not always the case, arid. Like ilazim is always the case. It's always the case. Sifat arida, we said, or we're going, or as I'm going to say, inshallah, today is sifat arida is 11 sifa. It's these 11 that you can see on the board, inshallah ta'ala. And we will take one after the other. And once we finish as-sifat al-arida, we have done what was needed. We've done the two most important, the most vital thing that everyone needs to know, Makharij al-Huruf and As-Sifat al-Huruf. Are we all together? So these are the 11 that we all need to know from Sifat al-Arida. And it's 11. The first one is? Al-Idgham. Al-Idgham, sorry. The first one is Al-Idgham. And the second one is? Al-Idhar. And the third one is? Al-Qalb. And the fourth one is الإخفاء. And the fifth one is المد. And the sixth one is القصر. And the seventh one is التحريك. And the eighth one is السكون. And the ninth one is السكت. The tenth one is التفخيم. And the 11th one is الترقيق. The order that we're going to be doing the classes in are not necessarily in the order that I wrote it now. Today, I'm going to do 10 and 11. Today's class, we're going to study التفخيم and الترقيق. Maybe we may not be able to finish that because that's a lot. We will not necessarily do it in this order. Are we all together? And once we finish Sifat Aridah, the test inshallah ta'ala will come where you'll be all asked, what was it that we studied? What I want you to understand is, I will do one day revision. I'll go over it quickly. Because remember, it was very long. It was many months that we were doing this. Sah? What we'll do inshallah ta'ala is, one day I'm going to summarize everything. So I will refresh it for you inshallah ta'ala. So we're going to do at-tafkhim and at-tarqiq, okay? We're going to do at-tafkhim and at-tarqiq. At-tafkhim wa at-tarqiq. At-tafkhim wa at-tarqiq. These are the sifat arida. We're going to do two from the 11. And always as we do, we explain each word, what it means in the Arabic language and what it also means according to the scholars of Tajweed. That's what Lughatan and Istilahan means. Lughatan means in the Arabic language, what does it mean? And Istilahan means according to the scholars of Tajweed. What do they mean by this word? What does it mean to them? So At-Tafkhim. What does At-Tafkhim mean in the Arabic language? تعريف التفخيم لغة it means التسمين. تسمين it means when something is chubby, fat. صح؟ What do you call a fat person in Arabic? سمين, right? سمين is a what? I never call a person fat, okay? It's not nice. Never call someone fat or chubby because it's not a nice thing to say. لكن what is it? It means سمين. سمين means big, chubby, fat. Here it means heavy. As Unais mentioned, it means heavy, okay? Istilahan, according to the scholars of At-Tajweed, pay attention. Unais, pay attention. According to the scholars of At-Tajweed, At-Tafkhim means it is heaviness. It's heaviness that enters. It's heaviness that enters السمن يدخل على الحرف عند النطق به. It is a what? It is سمن. سمن here means what? التسمين, right? It is سمن يدخل على الحرف, which enters the word. It's heaviness that enters into the word عند النطق به, when you want to pronounce it, there's this heaviness that enters the what? It enters the word. It is heaviness that enters the word عند النطق به, when you pronounce it. When you're pronouncing it, what's happening? It becomes heavy. فَيَمْتَلِئُ الْفَمُ, the mouth becomes heavy when you're saying it. As we're going to see, Allah, Allah. So you can't say Allah, Allah, Allah. If you say it like that, Allah, Allah, you can't. Allah. Tafkhim. Are we all together? Does that make sense? ويقابله الترقيق. What is the opposite of tafkhim? ويقابله الترقيق. الترقيق is the opposite of التفخيم. What is it? So if this is heavy, this is going to be what? ترقيق. ويقابله, what does it mean ويقابله, meaning the opposite. Are we all together, is what الترقيق, it is الترقيق. وهو, and the ترقيق is لغة, in the Arabic language it's التنحيف. تنحيف means what, نحيف. It's the opposite of التسمين. It's to be skinny. Nahif is a person who's skinny. Okay? Not a person who's built like me. MashaAllah, Allah barik. Salam barik. So, what does at-tarqiq mean? Lugatan. At-tanhif. What does tanhif mean? Skinny. But like in here, what does it mean? Light. It's the opposite of heavy, it's light. Wastilahan. Stilahan is what? Nuhul. Nuhul means what? التنحيل. It is lightness. رقة. It's very light. يلحق الحرف, which catches up with the word, enters into the word, it's caught up with the word, عند النطق به, when you're trying to pronounce it. There's a lightness in what? The word when you're saying it, and when you're pronouncing it. We're going to see the words which are the seven letters. There are tarqiq, we're going to see, and the remaining are going to be what? We're going to see the huruf which are tafkhim, and then we're going to see, and the opposite of course is going to be at-tarqiq. The seven which are tafkhim, and the opposite is what? At-tarqiq. We're going to see what they are, inshallah ta'ala, very soon. But before we go into which letters they are, we have to understand, when it comes to at-tarqiq, and when it comes to at-tafkhim, both of them, the word, it's three types. How many types are tarqiq and tafkhim? Three types. There are three types. The first one, which is huruf mufakhama da'iman. Always they are what? They're always mufakham. Meaning, you make it what? Mufakham means what? At-tafkhim. You make it heavy. It's always heavy. There's not a situation except it's heavy. The second type, which huruf muraqqaqa, daiman, always it's what? It's light on the tongue. It's light when you are articulating it, and it's light when you're pronouncing it. Does that make sense? And the third type is huruf tufakhamu fi halatin wa turaqqaqu fi halatin ukhra. Sometimes it is what? Heavy, and sometimes those same words, I mean, those same letters are what? Light. So that same letter sometimes is what? And sometimes is what? Does that make sense to everybody here? We're gonna show, yeah, you're right. We're gonna show the examples for each one, and we're gonna study each of these points now. So right now what we're gonna do is, we're going to study حروف مفخمة دائماً, حروف مرققة دائماً, and حروف تفخم في حالات وترقق في حالات أخرى. Are we all together? So far, does that make sense to everybody? Does it? So first of all, what are the letters which are حروف مفخمة? So what is it? خصة. So it's seven. What is it? خصة ضغط هي قض, right؟ خ صاد ضاد. خصة ضغط غين ط قاف and also ضاء. These are it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, all in one wording, all in these wordings, which is khussa, taghtin, and qid. Those are the seven. Okay, these seven that you can actually see here on the board, they are huruf mufakhama, right? Are they huruf tafkhim? Are they, yes or no? What is the remaining? Huh? The remaining is what? Am I making sense to all of you? Have you understood what I said? So this is the definition of what at-tafkhim means. This is the definition of what at-tarqiq means. And these are the types in which the tafkhim and the tarqiq are broken into. The tafkhim, those are huruf which are mufakhama da'iman, and there are huruf which are muraqqaqa da'iman, and there are huruf which are mufakhama fi halatin and muraqqaqa fi halatin ukhra. I don't have much time, so let me explain this inshallah ta'ala. We divided the at-tafkhim and the tarqiq into how many types? The tafkhim and the tarqiq, how many types did we divide it into? Into three types, right? Huruf mufakhama da'iman. They always have tafkhim on it, regardless. And the second one was huruf muraqqaqa da'iman. And the third one was huruf tufakhamu fi halatin wa turaqqaqu fi halatin ukhra, right? Sometimes there's tafkhim on it, or sometimes there's tarqiq on it. And those are the three that I said, each one we're going to study properly and what it means, and we'll take examples. First one that we have to understand, number one, which is huruf mufakhama da'iman. There's always tafkhim on it. Are we all together? There is always what? Tafkhim on it. And that is the huruf al-isti'la and the itbaq that we studied, remember, which is all of these seven. Remember? These seven are the huruf al-isti'la, sahih? Is it not? It is. And the sad, and the dad, and the ta, and the da are what? Itbaq, right? Huruf al-itbaq. Those four. So we have huruf al-isti'la, which is all seven. And we have what? Huruf al-itbaq. You have to go back to your notes. You have to go back to your notes and look at it. And make sure you keep memorizing these things. All of the huruf al-isti'la, the huruf al-isti'la that we took before, and the itbaq that we also took before, are all what? They are huruf mufakhama da'iman. They always have what? They're always heavy, which is this one. All these seven are always heavy. Khussa, dhagtin, qidh is always what? It's always heavy. And its heaviness is not the same. Are we all together? Is the heaviness all the same? No. It's levels. Levels. The strongest to the weakest. But they all are mufakhama. But of course, it's not all of that. All on the same level. The strongest of them is what? Al-maftuh alladhi ba'dahu alifun wa huwa aqwaha. Like qala. Qala. Are we all together? Qala is a what? Is it from the huruf? Yeah, it is. It is. Qaf is, right? But what is after it? Alladhi ba'dahu. An alif. Qala is, there's alif in there, sah? In ilm al-sarf, they call this ajwaf, right? It's ajwaf. There's a alif there. Okay? وَهُوَ أَقْوَاهَا. This is the heaviest one. Qala. Qala. It's the heaviest one. It's the strongest form. And then second is what? Al-maftuh. Al-qasas. Qasas. Qasas. It's maftuh. الذي ليس بعده ألف. There is no ألف after it. Like the قصص, the قاف. Are we all together? The third one is المضموم. There's just a dhamma on it. There's a dhamma on it. It's not a fatha. What is it? قو قرآنا قر قر. المضموم means there's a dhamma on it. Fourth one is الساكن. The قاف has a sukun on it. Sakinu means what? There's a sukun on it. Taqa, 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 susil qasasa. Taqa, susil qasasa. What's on the qaf? There is a sukun on it. And last but not least, al-maksur. Maksur means what? There's a kasra on it. What do you say? Ta-qi. Ta-qi. Ta-qilun. That's the levels of what? Huruf mufakhama. The levels of these ones. Okay? The level. All of you, write that inshallah ta'ala. Now we're going to go into... Yeah, you can go to the washroom. Now we're going to go into the second type of at-tarqiqu wa at-tafhimu. We divided it into three. We've done the first, and now we're going to move on to the huruf muraqqaqa da'iman. Always is what? It's always muraqqaqa, meaning it's always light. It's not a heavy. What was the opposite of isti'la? Remember when we took huruf isti'la? Does anyone remember? What was the opposite of it? When we spoke about isti'la, what was the second one that we mentioned? Do you remember? We mentioned the sifat of al-istifal, right? The sifat of isti'la, what did we say? How many are isti'la? How many huruf were the isti'la? Seven, right? Did we not say that? Those seven were hurufu isti'la. And huruf al-istifal was what? The remaining, other than those seven. Anything other than those seven letters, we said they're called what? Hurufu? Hurufu istifal. Meaning these seven are hurufu isti'la, and they fall into which one? The first type, which is huruf mufakhama da'iman. And the remaining of these seven are called what? What's it called? Huruf istifal, remember. They're what? Huruf istifal. Huruf istifal is muraqqaqa da'iman. Does that make sense? Huruf istifal is always what? Muraqqaqa da'iman ma'ada thalatha, except three. Except what? Three are not. They are what? They are an exception. They're the ones that are going to enter here. Does that make sense to everyone? So these seven, where do they enter? Pay attention. Slowly understand the point I'm trying to say. Huruf isti'la. Isn't this huruf isti'la? These seven, are they not huruf isti'la? These seven, are they not huruf isti'la? Yes or no? Yes, they are. And four of them is huruf al-itbaq, which was the ta, sad, ta. Those four are mutbaqa, right? Those four are mutbaqa. These seven, they all enter into this place. Where do they enter? Into this place. The remaining other than these seven are called what? Hurufu? Istifal, right? Istifal enters here. Where does it enter? Huruf which are muraqqaqa da'iman. Always there's what? It's always light. Except what? Except three letters. I haven't said the letters yet. What are they? Three letters. Those three letters, which are the exception of al-istifal, they enter what? They enter to third category. They enter, the letters are alif, lam, and ra. Alif, lam, and what? Ar-ra. So, pay attention here, please. So, pay attention. These seven, where do they enter? Where did these seven enter? They are muraqqaqa. Mufakhama. Da'iman. Always there's tafkheem on it. Correct? Yes? No? Yes. Okay. Jameel. And the remaining alphabet letters, where do they enter? Huruf muraqqaqa da'iman. Except what? Alif, lam, and? Where do they go then? حروف تفخم في حالات وترقق في حالات أخرى. We will leave that for next lesson, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.